for today's video, because today you're going to see a lot of the behind the scenes. And I've spent a lot of time trying to set everything up. And I want to start with the fact that, one, I love Stampin' Up! Products. And one of the reasons why I joined as a demonstrator was not only for the business side of it, because I was really looking for something that would kind of enhance and things that I would enjoy, and I love crafting. But you also, as a demonstrator, you get a 20% discount on anything that is in the catalog. And so when you order, as if you're just a hobbyist and you're just looking for that discount, joining gives you an opportunity to get 20% off of anything that's in the book. And if you decide to go for the business model, then you have an opportunity to move up from there and to earn a lot more depending on your level. But being a Stampin' Up! Demonstrator has given me access to a lot of really great items. And some of these were things that I didn't have to start with. And so it was great. And what I learned is that, you know, not only do they have the really great tools and things, but you also have an opportunity to get to enjoy some of the really great products that they have. The paper is absolutely phenomenal. I actually talked about the paper, any of the paper, it's like all the way through the ink is. It is acid free. You can use it for scrapbooking and keeping your memories safe. And so I really enjoy that you're getting a product that is not going to be wasted. But I am a hoarder, and so what I'm going to show you is I have this lovely basket, and this is where all of my all of my lovely scraps go into. And I do have things that are not scraps, that are not Stampin' Up!, and I'm going to set that aside because I'm going to talk about that for a moment. But I don't throw away anything. And there's a reason why I don't throw away things, is because sometimes you may have something as, let's see, we'll talk about if you have like one of the little punches. These little pieces right here, very, very small. And so something as simple as, you know, part of this would work. And so you don't want to waste anything. And I do plan to put together a tutorial and show you how I'm going to use a lot of this stuff. As a matter of fact, I was thinking about going through today, and you can see where I've punched out like lots of little pieces out of that one. I even have in here mistakes. So I had mistakes. Well, I'm not going to throw that away because I had a mistake. I'm going to turn around and use that on something else and create a different card. But don't throw away little scraps, because I will show you how you can take little scraps and put that on paper and create a whole new piece of paper and use it in ways that you didn't think that you could. But I do have a very huge scrap bin, and it's starting to overflow, so it is time to start pulling out some projects out of this and using it for something else. And I do have like bigger sheets toward the back and some of my little smaller pieces. But if you are, you know, if you're a demonstrator, they want you to use their products, and I love their products, but am I going to throw away something that I bought 10 years ago just because I started selling Stampin' Up? No. And the reason why is because I'm going to utilize every single thing that I have, because I am very budget conscious, money conscious, just, you know, everything. And I'm not going to turn around and tell you, hey, this is Stampin' Up! Stuff when it's not. These are things that I had From when I scrapbooked a long time ago. I think I started scrapbooking in 2001 or 2002, so about 15 years. I have 15 years worth of things. I'm not going to throw those things away. I am going to use them. I love the idea. I love the fact that Stampin' Up, puts out new products and new papers. For example, some of the things that I have purchased through them. Last year, I purchased their. There's a scrap I didn't see. I purchased some of their specialty paper, and this is just part of it, part of the specialty papers that I've purchased. And I wish that, because these are no longer available, that I would have purchased more. But I hang on to them and I use them. And like I said, I love the fact that they are always about putting out new things, whether it's new stamps, new stamp colors, and those things. So it's always changing, it's always fresh, and it's always new. But being a Stampin' Up! Demonstrator, does that mean that you're gonna have to go out and go all out about buying and putting together a whole lot of items and putting together, a place to make videos? I make videos because I enjoy making videos. But here's a little behind the scenes. So let me remove my camera from the stand. And so this is, you may notice, it's a selfie stick. So I have attached a selfie stick to a tripod that I own. And that becomes my overhead camera station, if you will. I have lights that I have purchased, or I could always film near the window, and the window has light colored curtains, and everything in here is white, so it reflects light. But those are like simple things that I have. The camera that I am currently using, I will actually put that in the, I'll put that, hi, I'll actually put that in the description box at the bottom. As a matter of fact, I'll even put the lighting, that I use. That'll also be in the description box. You'll find that below. But this is basically one of those little cheap, like a GoPro. It's the Vivitar. And it works really well. It sits inside. Before I had this, I actually had another camera that I no longer own anymore. But I had that camera, and it was on, of all things, a wire clothes hanger that my son helped me bend and design so that it hung over everything. And so it's not about turning around and trying to create or recreate the wheel. Something as simple as your phone can be used to create videos, and you can then upload those videos to YouTube. And that's a great way in order to help promote your business. So today was all about providing you with a little bit behind the scenes, if you will. My work area for my work area for the most part, I try to keep everything handy. I have like a magnet sheet hung up, and you'll notice that some of my little thin luck dies, that I put those there so that they're handy whenever I am making cards. I keep my acrylic blocks and my inks. All of these things are kept within arm's reach. The desk that I have was something that we found at a thrift store, and it enables me to kind of keep everything that I need handy. So I have my
embossing powders. I have my thinlets and my embossing folders in this, and once it gets too large to go in there, I don't know what I'm gonna do with it. Ribbons and things that I find, old stamps that I had, new stamps that aren't my, because these are my Stampin' Up! Stamp sets, and so I kind of keep those together with my Big Shot. But I find ribbon things that I like to use.
Ooh.
Excuse me. Ooh, okay. But I keep my larger papers in this, especially my 12 by 12s, because my 12 by 12s would not fit in my little hanger over there. I bought one of those. It's like an organizer for school, and I got it pretty cheap at Walmart. And so I use that to keep everything, including my shipping supplies. And then I have some of my little hand punches there. I have those that I keep handy. And I still have a lot of junk that's just sitting around my room because I'm still trying to organize things. But that's a very quick look at some of the behind the scenes things that I have going on. But like I said, I'll put some of that information below if you're looking for it. I don't know if there are others out there who are trying to possibly get started on the video making tutorials and things. But you may want to know how to do that. And YouTube is really great. It's a great tool to use not only for the card making tutorials, but to reach and get a further reach on things. And then you have the whole possibility of making money on the side with YouTube. So having that possibility of having some passive income come in, and passive just means that it's not something that you are doing because as part of your business. It's just something that's happening because of your business. And so I think that that's a great way for anyone who is looking to possibly get another revenue stream coming in. That's a way to do it. So hope you enjoyed this. See you. Be sure to check out my website. My website is www.justmarthadesigns.com, and I am Martha Thurston. Nice to meet you. Bye.